A very misunderstood formula relating to pivot tables is the GETPIVOTDATA function. Most people know this as just an annoyance, but it actually is a very useful tool. So just to explain it first, if I'm outside a pivot table and I want to click somewhere in it, so let's say I want to go equals, and I just want to know the weekday total for March. If I click on that cell, instead of just saying E13 equals E13, it sometimes puts this whole formula in GETPIVOTDATA, etc. And what you realize is if you copy this down, for some reason it repeats itself. So let's just understand this. Now it's quite a difficult one to build up on its own, but it's actually a fairly simple formula. So what you saw is we clicked and we said equals here. If I look at the formula, we can kind of get a sense of what it's trying to do. So you'll see it's saying the data field is the bill, because we've got sum of bill, so it's looking at the bill. The pivot table it's saying is A6, so it's just telling us that in the pivot table starting at A6, there's something. Then you'll see it says weekday weekend is the field, so it's that one there, and it's specified that it must be weekday. Then notice it mentions the field is the month over here, and it specifies that the month must be March. And notice that you can put in more fields and items. So what this is effectively telling Excel is please go find the number that's at the intersection of the weekday and the month of March, and it'll pull that number up. Now why this is so important is remember we can sort these, we can move these, pivot tables grow, they shrink. So let's go here, and let's just sort it Z to A. Notice March is moved here. The number I was looking for is now here, but notice that that's still looking at it. So this is almost like a VLOOKUP for pivot tables. It doesn't matter where this moves, as long as you've told it where the intersection is, in this case weekday and March, it will then find it. Because this is a normal formula, the reason when you copy it down is because this cell here is also looking for the intersection of the weekday and March. So if we want that to change, we need to replace weekday and March with something else. Now we could do it directly in the formula, but let's rather do this. I'll type January up here, and let's put weekend here. And now I'm going to alter this formula, and where it says weekday, instead of typing it in, I'm going to say look at that cell there. And where it says March, I'm going to say look at that cell there. And when I say OK, notice it gives me 377, the intersection of weekend over here, and January, there's the 378. So now we can actually control this. If I type the word March, this formula goes into the pivot table and finds the relevant intersection. Let's make this slightly more complex. So I'm going to go and I'm going to insert day of the week. So now we've got a very big one, split by weekday, day of the week, destination, network, and month. I now want to create a formula, and let's say I'm going to say equals. For now, I'm going to say I want to see what happens to MTN in January on Monday, which is a weekday. So you'll see it creates that formula. If I actually look at it, I can see all the components. So I'm just going to create some references here. So I'm going to type MTN weekday. I'm going to put a 1 and type January. And now I can go to this formula and change it. So the destination network is someone's typed in MTN. I'm going to say look over there. The day of the week, I'm going to say look over there. Is it a weekday or weekend? Look over there. And the month, look over there. So when I say OK, I get 1863. But now I can actually change this and maybe make it a Wednesday, a 3. Gives me a 0 because MTN in January on a Wednesday, nothing. Let's change this to March. I get a number of 41, and that's because in March the MTN calls with 41. So using GETPIVOTDATA, you can get a pivot table, build it, let it do all the hard work, and then you can extract the information you want and make it customizable. You can get these formulas to search for the numbers that you're actually looking for.